Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you how to use the Twitter, the Facebook, the GitHub, all the social accounts to get authenticated in your website hosted on Azure. In a project I'm working on, I wanted the user to be authenticated, but I didn't want to manage all the password forget and all those forms. So I thought, what if I could use social login to do it? Well, it's very simple and I will show you how to get started. In this video, I will use a .NET Core application just because it's easier for me, but be sure that it's working with all the JavaScript and other languages. So let's get started. So first, we'll create a new web app just to get started. So here I'm using Blazor server. Like I said, it could be anything else. The beauty here is I'm using authentication individual, so the login screen and a few little things will all be already be implemented for me. So now let's go in this specific folder. In this demo, I will use Twitter API to get authenticated. Not because it's better, just because I picked one. So to be able to use it in my code, I will need to use to add a package. So if I was using Node, it will be an npm something. Here I'm with .NET Core, so it's .NET add package. And then here I'm using version 3, just because on this laptop right now, version 3.1 is not installed, but of course it's supported. Perfect, so now let's open the code to see what it looks like. Perfect. So if I open the project file here, we'll see that my package is added. Excellent. Let's modify quickly one page so we know it's our app. So we'll go in page, I will pick the index and welcome to your new Cloud 5 Minutes. Let's go. Minutes app. Great. So let's close this. And now before going too far, let's look what we have. So what's been scaffold for us? So in the area section, I have account and I have in share a partial login. So that was one of the pages that was generated for us when we added the authentication individual. And you will see later that will have in the top right corner of the scaffold website, a place to register and login. How can we add more things and use Twitter? So if we go in the startup page, in the configuration service section, we'll add a new part of code. So just align that better. And we'll add a authentication and we'll add Twitter. Here, if we were about to use more social authentication, we'll just queue them. So add Twitter, add Facebook, add GitHub, add Microsoft, all. And now I'm passing two specific parameters here, and it's the consumer key and the consumer secret. We'll need to create an application in the Twitter API to generate those keys and we'll use them. But of course, I don't want those value inside my app settings because it's very sensible. So I will show you a nice trick to use those keys without being visible. But the name here, website authentication, Twitter consumer key, it needs to be that specific name. I will show you shortly where that name comes from. Now, talking about the devil, we need to have those keys. So let's go on the Twitter developer website and get our keys. To get there, we need to go to developertwitter.com. And here I have other apps. Let's create a new one by clicking the blue button. So we need a name, a description, a URL. So here the URL, don't be afraid, you can change those, but it needs to be a valid URL. Of course, don't forget to check that little enable sign in with Twitter, otherwise you won't get far. One of the most important part is the callback URL. So now what I will do is using my Azure website address and add the sign in Twitter. This part is really important. So we'll do this. And to be able to also debug locally, what you can do is add another one. Of course, don't do that while in production, but you can do add localhost and sign in Twitter. It will also work if you're working locally. Now, all other values are optional except this description here. I'm creating. Now, my application is creating, and to get my key, my API key and secret, I need to go here in keys and tokens. So I click here and I'll have my value. So I'm showing you that because after recording this demo, I will delete everything, but usually you will never show those values. So copy paste that on the side. I will show you how to use them. Now I'm back in my terminal and I want to show you a nice trick to use those keys locally. So what you can do is use here .NET user secret and you will pass the same variable with your secret. So you do that for both and they will be in your environment variables. So this way your website will be able to reach them, but they won't be visible and you won't push it to Git or GitHub accidentally. So it's way more secure. So you do that for both. Little typo here, voila. Excellent. So now if I go back in Visual Studio Code and I run, I will be able to experience my new website. So let's have a look. And voila, we have the new website. And like I mentioned here in the corner, the top right corner, we have register and login. So let's try it. So I will log in. So now here I have the usual login. I can completely remove that part if I really don't want to manage user, password and all those things and keep the Twitter. This part was added just by the little code snippet we had, so I can click the button and now I'm redirect to Twitter. I authorize the application and now I can just specify my email and register. Voila, now I'm registered to my application. Excellent. How can you manage those keys in Azure? Let's see that. So now I will quickly deploy the code. There's many different ways to deploy the code. Since I'm in Visual Studio Code, I will use that one. If you want to know other ways to deploy a web app, I will put a link in the top right corner. Have a look if you're interested. Great. So now the code is in Azure. So let's go in the Azure portal to finish the configuration. So this is the resources I deploy, and this is the website. So we'll click on that. And remember, I told you we won't use the configuration because this is very visual. So instead, what will be is here in the left section, in under the settings sections, we'll click on authentication and authorization. Then we'll turn it on, and we'll have different options here to use different auth system. So we are using Twitter, so we click on Twitter and you will enter your key and secret. Don't forget to save. Voila. And now let's go back in the overview. And if I click here, I have my website. So it's the same website as usual. And I have my registration. So if I try to log in, I can use Twitter. And boom, voila, I'm in, as simple. And remember, since I was using the same application in Twitter, the same Twitter API application, that's why I didn't need to click again the authorize button from Twitter, because I'm using the same one. In the real world, dev should be using a very different application than in prod, but since here it's just a demo, I was using the same. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. If you have any questions, you can ask them in the comment section. I'm always happy and I try to do my best to answer it. Talking about questions, let's read some that you sent me. So first questions today comes from Raul. Hey Frank, great video. Can you help me to extract data from D365, so Dynamics, true data entities into blob using Logic App? Well, I'm not the best one for Dynamics 360 because I don't use it a lot. So quickly I saw that there's plenty of connectors. So if I'm not mistaken, you're probably just need to go there, add the connector and everything will be working automatically. So second question here from Ayan is asking, thanks for the video. Are there PowerShell steps to accomplish this? And it was in the video where I was deploying Docker container and I was using Azure CLI. So of course, everything that is possible in PowerShell is possible in Azure CLI and the other way around. So it's always possible, and it's also possible through the portal. So last questions come from Chris. So he's using TFS 2017 with the task build. They are done in YAML, and he's looking forward to use Azure DevOps and would like to see if it's possible to migrate to YAML, if there's a conversion system that exists where you put the file in one place and just get out in the other format. The system are that different that there's no conversion system that exists. Well, or at least not that I know. I asked around and that was mostly the same answer I got every time. So I'm sorry about that. Though if you put them side by side, the logic should be the same. It's just they're using different formats. And that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you next time.